So continuing with more weapon modeling techniques, another thing we can do to create detail on our weapon is to use polygon planes. So polygon planes are single sheets of polygons that we can use and manipulate as we wish, and they work slightly differently to cubes. The beauty of these is that we can almost draw on these and create outlines of our image and then extrude them to create objects from it. So what I'm going to do is position this polygon plane roughly over this top bit of my weapon here, and then add in some more detail afterwards. So I'm going to bring it up and just start scaling it so it's roughly matching up with my image. And I'm actually going to go to face mode now and delete the unnecessary faces, so you can get rid of things straight away and just work with the polygons that you need. So I'm going to go to the same technique as always, row of vertices and then use them where you need them. So you can see I'm just going row by row, dragging over them and then moving them to match the outline of my image. Move along. Next one. I'm also using the handles to do this instead of grabbing the square, because that will keep them in line when I'm moving left and right. They're not going to move them up and down by accident. Let's just move all these to match up there. And then this will come out here. Okay, cool. So I'm going to do the same thing, and I'm now going to delete the other faces that we don't need. So I'm going to delete all of these. I'm going to delete these bits here. Oops, I haven't done that one just yet. But you can see on the top bit, on the end of my weapon, I've got obviously more of a curvature here for the pistol. So what I need to do is use a tool here to actually draw in the line and create the detail that I want. So you can use the multi-cut tool to do this, and instead of holding down control and creating edge loops, we're going to click on the vertice and then move it and draw this line, follow the line. So if I click and drag on this edge, you can see I can actually create a new vertex on this edge. I'm going to use that just there, and I'm going to use that just there. So I've done a combination. I've used actually clicking on the vertex, clicking and dragging on the edge to create a breakpoint, and then just clicking on the vertices just here. And then if you hit enter, it will create more detail for us. So then I can go back to face mode, delete these faces that I've created that are not needed. And I can start to make this into a 3D object. So at the minute, like I say, we've only got a single plane here. Now, the extrude tool will work the same way for edges as it does for faces. And what we can do is, if I just show you this, if I go to edge mode and just pick a couple of these edges, holding down shift and extrude, you can use these handles to then pull out and create your 3D shape. So you're actually turning your flat plane into a 3D object. So what I'd suggest you do is go along all of the edges that you want to extrude out and pull them out, and then you can add your bevel into it and tweak your vertices as you need to match it up with the image. Remember, when you're modeling weapons, if we were to look down on top of this, we'd only be modeling half of it, so I would then mirror this over once we've done and create this side of the weapon. So I'm not too worried if the edge on this side isn't joined up and it's a closed shape in itself. It doesn't matter, because we can mirror the whole thing over in the end. Okay, so that is using polyplanes and using multi-cut tool to create more detail on our polyplanes, and then removing the needed faces, and then the extruding edge tool to then bring this out.